Want to make the most out of the planning features in SAP Analytics Cloud? Tables offer a range of ad hoc planning options to help you get the job done. In a table, the values that can be edited appear in black, and those that can't are gray. Keep in mind that your role and permissions affect what data you can edit. The table displays a forecast in which planning is complete up to until the end of Q3, where values are scaled to show in millions of US dollars. The Q4 values are unbooked and ready for planning, indicated by the dashes in the cells. You can choose the table type you want to work with, either the default crosstab or a forecast layout, which lets you display different versions of your data before and after a specific cutover date. By default, unbooked members aren't visible in a table, but you can enable the option for the relevant rows and columns. You can also choose the data entry mode you want: single, to process data changes after each entry; fluid, to recalculate values together for changes made in quick succession; or mass data, to make multiple changes and choose when to process the calculations. You can take a granular approach to planning by entering data in a leaf cell, meaning a cell at the bottom of its respective hierarchies. To enter a value, you can type the full number, use a word to specify the unit, or indicate the unit with a single letter. The value aggregates up the time, month, and product hierarchies, with yellow highlighting to show the affected cells. You can delete the value from a cell to return it to an unbooked state. To take a broader approach to planning, you can enter values in non-leaf cells. For example, when you enter a value in an empty parent cell, the value is automatically disaggregated and distributed between the leaf cells in each hierarchy. Each child cell in a hierarchy gets the same amount. There are several ways to edit existing cell values. You can enter a new value to overwrite the existing one, or use symbols to change the relative value by multiplying, dividing, adding a percentage, adding a number, or subtracting a number. Keep in mind that you need to add a negative number to subtract from a value. When you change the value, it affects all the leaf cells proportionally, preserving the existing ratios between the values. One way to speed up your planning is to copy and paste values between cells, or from cells in other tables, grid pages, or spreadsheet documents. Keep in mind that when you copy the value from a non-leaf cell, all the underlying values that aggregate up to it are copied as well, as long as you paste to another cell at an equivalent level in the hierarchy, such as copying from Q3 to Q4. You can also paste overall values only if you don't want to keep the source distribution. For more refined control over the distribution of values between leaf cells, you can use the planning panel. Here, you can choose a source cell and either adjust its value and distribute the new total to the target leaf cells, or redistribute the existing amount between the leaf cells. For distribution, you can enter a value and either overwrite the original amount or book the new value as an additional amount. There are recommendations you can preview, such as distributing to product members one level below, redistributing among product members, distributing to time-month members one level below, or redistributing among time-month members. When you specify the amount to redistribute to each of the highlighted target cells, you can choose to overwrite or append the value, and choose a driver, allowing you to set values by using exact numbers, the weights or ratios between values, equally, giving each the same amount, or proportionally, preserving the existing proportions between the cells. For example, using weights, you can give one member twice the forecast value of the other members. All the affected cells highlight to show the new values. Finally, you can also add new members to your dimensions on the fly. When you enter a name in the cell, SAP Analytics Cloud checks if this is an existing member that's currently excluded, or if it's a new member. For new members, you're prompted to enter a description and ID, specify the currency, and choose the user responsible for planning. All All the cells for the new member are automatically unbooked and ready for values. This is just some of what you can do with planning using tables in SAP Analytics Cloud. For more information, check out the help topic links in the description and try it for yourself today.